He abhors the fat dauber.
He was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. He remembers me. Why, you... Oh, no, that's not right. Mokunohuntunkun. Aon-e-e-ko-no-tun-no-vun-no-ra.
Knows the pain of your loss. He will help you.
Curious.
What is it?
Oh, nothing to be concerned about.
What is he doing?
Making sure we're headed in the right direction. Listen closely now. We need two things to get us into the land of the giants. First, we need to learn the travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
That one on the peak where we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looked kind of mad for a moment there.
Now that... He thought I said you were friends of Odin. You'll forgive me. I never spoke in the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I haven't seen new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
One more for the collection. Ah, I can read what this says now. But it's a name. Air! Whoa! The name made it light up!
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
Nightmares, ugh! What awful pests!
Fire from behind! That was good, right?
Your skill continues to grow. Boy, over here.
Bet we'll find something useful here.
I have a favor to ask. Just a small favor, really. Do you remember the dagger you gave me?
The dagger stabbed into the Reaver's back? His own son killed him? Yeah, I haven't forgotten that one.
Well, I traced it to a group of Reavers that operate out of the Northree stronghold. I'd wager that's where they took their haul from Fafnir's storeroom, along with that whetstone that I could use to help you.
Another treasure hunt? Pointless.
Well, not if Sindri really can make us better equipment with that whetstone. Plus, the Reaver's son.
Retrieve the whetstone. Please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep going towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Ah, Fafnir. I always wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads?
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances. And not totally without reason.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad.
You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy.
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death. If only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me the bones, child.
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead past this gate.
Focus up, boy! This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Harimthor ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
A wolverine!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together. Ready yourself, boy! Chisel.
The tip of one, yes. A very, very giant chisel. Trick, lad.
Thanks. His idea. What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
This is locked up good.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Enemies. What should we do? I just wish they were harder. And I'll find Light Crystal. Wonder what it's for.
What does it say?
Yes, sir. To Njord, we offer back the sea's bounty.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
Base for the crystal we saw, but how do we get it down?
Atreus, to me!
How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Ready.